What's going on, everyone? Welcome, Rabbit here, and today we're taking a look at the current state of crypto mining for February of 2024. This is going to be a very exciting year. Profits are going to start picking up very soon. So we're going to be taking a look at GPUs, CPUs, ASICs, as well as FPGAs. All right, guys, so we're going to start things off here with GPUs. And GPUs is the most popular way to mine cryptocurrencies, but I have a feeling this cycle, it may be one of the least profitable ways to mine cryptocurrencies. But, you know, more on that in a different video. Here we are coming into the GPU mining department. We can see right off the get-go, I'm set at 11 cent per kilowatt hour here, and an RTX 4090 currently on a Leafium. It's making about $1.06 per day. Coming in for Hyper versus Leafium, it looks like 98 cents. Now, I am on the 24-hour average. If I go to current network conditions here, it's still showing us the same thing. So nothing did change there. We got the 4080 Super here. Looks like 56 cents a day on Leafium right across the board. Now, remember, the Bitstream just released for FPGAs, and as more people have been getting into FPGAs, we'll look at this later, but Leafium seems to be the dominant coin now, and they blow these GPUs out of the water. So the profits you see here are nothing compared to what the FPGAs are getting. And you can kind of go down the list here and see we got Pyron coming in at 40 here for Leafium, and I guess Hyper and Leafium here. Now, Pyron recently got listed on Binance Futures, not the spot yet, but it is on Futures. So it's very interesting to see what may happen if Binance actually adds Pyron to their spot trading. So that's really what matters when it comes for most of us miners. We don't care about the futures trading, it's all about the spot. The RTX 3090, again, Leafium and Chlor. Chlor is actually -7, where Leafium is looking like 36. This is all after power numbers at 11 cent. A lot of people out there have quite a bit more expensive power, so keep that in mind as well, 20 cent plus. The 4070, 30 cents and 30 cents. Now, the main go-to GPU I usually look at, it is the most popular GPU for crypto miners today, is the RTX 3070, and the profitability still isn't looking that great, only sitting around 16 cents. All right, so now we're gonna move on to CPUs, and CPUs have been pretty much dominating crypto mining over the past 2 years or so. And pretty much this entire bear market, CPUs have been pretty decent in profitability. So we're gonna load this up in 3900X here. Again, we're looking at 11 cent per kilowatt hour. Calculate that, we can see AVN is looking like 43 cents after power. Actually, things aren't looking too hot right now, but this is after power at 11 cents, so we can still see, you know, over versus like a 3070, it's about the same price depending on your used markets. It's different for everybody, but we're like over quadruple the profits of an RTX 3070 on a 3900X. So Reaction, 39 cents after power. Mechi AI here, 34 cents. Zephyr is down to only 32 cents here after power. Let's just jump into something a little bit bigger here. We're going to move up to the 7900X, which is 7000 series capabilities, one of the newer CPUs, newer architecture. They're just better CPUs in general. We do see Reaction is now 52 cents after power. Zeph is up to 48 cents. Mechi AI here is 46 cents. F Society, 45 cents. Coming back up, we're going to move now into the Epic 7742 range here, and I don't think I have all the algos tested here yet, but we do have most of the ones that most of us are mining anyway. So we do have Yatacoin $1.79 after power, Avian $1.74, Reaction is $1.56, Zeph is $1.49, Mechu AI $1.36, F Society $1.37. Now we're going to jump into the big bad boy dual Epic 7742. Calculate this out, and we can see Yatacoin is now $3.39 after power. Zeph is at $2.80 after power. Reaction, $2.73. Mechu AI thingamajigger, $2.41. F Society, $2.38. And it continues to go down. Now, the point is, there's a bunch of coins that are decent in profitability, especially for a bear market right now. All right, so now moving on to the ASIC side of things. And just like it was last month and the following month and every month before this, when the Caspa ASICs first emerged, they're still the top miner to have in your arsenal for the most amount of profitability. Now, obviously, the KS3, when it first dropped, was over $3,000 a day. That is only down to $58 a day now. Obviously, we had some block reductions, hash rate caps. Caspa hash rate has been exploding, as well as the price has been coming down. Regardless, they are still the top profitability miners here. And we can have KS3, KS3s, KS3Ms. Fancy moving up here, though, we have the Apollo G1, which is currently sitting at $14.38 a day. We do have the S21 Bitcoin miner, which uses over 5,000 watts. That's only making $12, not too hot. Now, this is after power. You got to give them that argument. But the halving is coming as well. So technically, this is only going to be making $6 a day, you know, in the next 2 or 3 months, whenever that halving does actually happen. Again, we got another Bitcoin miner here, almost $12 a day. But this one, wow, 7,000 watts. That's an insane amount of power. We do have the KS2 is down to $11.16, but still not too shabby there. The X16P, $9.78. And then it looks like a bunch of Bitcoin miners are up here. Now, one of the miners that's kind of been flying under the radar, in my honest opinion, is the Bitmain X5, which we thought could only mine Monero. It can mine a couple other coins right now, and it's looking like it is sitting anywhere between $12 to $16 a day and only uses 1,300 watts. So that's one I definitely have on my radar and one maybe you guys should look out as well, but it seems to be out of stock everywhere. I don't know if Bitmain only made like 5 units and that's it, but seems to be an issue finding the X5 anywhere. Regardless, this is the top profitable ASICs right now, and it looks like it's still swamped by most of the higher big end Caspa ASICs right now. And as always, if you guys are looking for any type of ASIC miners, I highly urge you guys to head on over to Crypto Miner Bros. My code RABID will grant you $50 off your order. All the prices you see does include shipping, and they drop the value so that import fees are next to nothing. So make sure you use that link down in the description, and code RABID will grant you $50 off your order for these ASIC miners. All right, and last and certainly not least, we got some FPGAs. So the only ones I've personally tested was the E300 and the C1100 I've only got running on Ironfish so far. So once I try other coins, I will update this sheet so you guys can know what's going on. Sounds like a Leafium Bitstream should emerge for the C1100 and other FPGAs out there as well very, very soon. And once that's ready, I'll definitely have the numbers here as well. So anyway, we got the E300 coming into KylaCoin. Ignore the color scheme, and I didn't update that, but the numbers are current as of this very second at the time recording based on price and network conditions. So KylaCoin right now at 18 gigahash, which is running decently efficient here, before power, that's $4.07. After power, the profit is $2.67. Ironfish seems to have a little bit of a hash rate increase over the past couple days here, but 152 gigahash there at $3.45 before power is $2.82 after power. It's pretty cheap here, only 63 cents in power costs as all this runs at 239 watts. Now, Ironfish is set to fork sometime soon here. You know, I wouldn't hold my breath on that, but it's supposed to be forking over. So that is GPU only, and it's anti-FPGA and ASIC. So we'll see what happens when that emerges. But right now, you still can mine Ironfish with FPGAs, but it's not the top coin, which it has been for the past few months or so. Moving on to Radiant, some interesting things I've been having with Radiant. The hash rate has actually been dropping off Radiant. Let's just have a quick look here and look at RXD. We'll look at Radiant here, and you can see hash rate has been pulling off the network right here, and it's actually been moving over, it seems like, over to Alephium. So I'm just going to punch in Alephium here, and we can see the hash rate has been gaining. So since the Bitstream's emerging, since Alephium has been doing quite a bit better in profitability, we are seeing those miners pull away and move to Alephium. But as of it looks right now, before power, $3.22 on the efficient settings. I can crank this up and get a lot more hash rate out of this on Radiant, but I'm talking, I usually run my stuff fairly efficient here, and we are at $3.22 before power, or $1.72 after power. Now, here's the big one when it comes to the E300 and the latest Bitstream that's dropping on the FPGAs. Alephium. So right now we are almost at $5. So $4.97 before power and $4.13 after power. We're only using 84 cents worth of power here per 24 hours to run these highly efficient FPGAs mining Alephium. And now moving on to the C1100, which again, I only have numbers for Ironfish. It is making about $1.11 before power and 90 cents after power. All right, guys, so there we have it. That is the current state of crypto mining profitability right now as of February 2024. And I like to kind of keep track of this stuff. I didn't do it last cycle here. So now we can look back when the bull run hits and see what our yields kind of look like and compare that to what yields look like when the bull run finally hits and see, you know, get a lot of like, oh, I wish I was mining back then, but the profit didn't look good. Now the profit's good, but our yields really suck. So in theory, right now, we are probably mining three times the profitability at least of what we will be getting if you sell that in the next year and a half when the full-fledged bull run is on. So thank you for checking out this video, guys. Let me know what you are mining. What's your favorite type of mining hardware down in the comment section. Hit that subscribe button. I'll see you on the next one. Rabbit out.